Hey everyone, so this is a bit different. It will make sense in a future video. You'll see why. I'm not going to go into explanations now. Videos on this channel will be a little bit choppy because I've been doing some things outside of YouTube, which are quite important. I've got to do some contract work and you'll find out, and this will make sense later. But first I want to talk, there's a couple of things I want to mention before we get into this video, because this video is going to be like a dream vlog about a really intense dream I had last night, or a couple of dreams I had last night, all to do with like superpowers and things, so it's going to be a good story. The first thing I want to talk about is my Patreon page. If all things go well and everyone doesn't delete their Patreon stuff with me, next month, November, should be the most financially successful month on Patreon that I've ever had. And that's just incredible from the get-go. That makes me feel good, especially with the things that, you know, the explanation of this and stuff. It makes me feel very good, and I want to say a big thank you. And that's partly due to the fact that I've brought back the coaching service. So if you are a person who is really struggling with lucid dreaming, then check out the Patreon page for the coaching service. Also, the second and final announcement is that I'm a guest host on a regular podcast. Somebody that I know, Gary, he has this network type thing called Target Reference, and part of it is a small weekly updated podcasting, and it's all about nerdy stuff, so comic books, TV shows, films, all of that good stuff, video games occasionally, all the good stuff that makes geeky people geeky. Yeah, it's a good little podcast. We've only released a couple of episodes called Total Fandom, and if you want to have a listen, then links in the description box below. So, with the dream. So the first, I had two really intense and really long dreams, and I thought I'd been asleep for ages, and I thought I'd overslept, and I woke up in the morning thinking that, oh god, I think I've slept too much, and I checked my phone and it said 9:30, and I thought, well, that's pretty good. I thought it was like 11:30, 12 o'clock, but this is great. And the reason I thought it was so late is because the length of these dreams were really long, really, really long. So the first dream, I had, I was in like a city, and I think it was New York. I don't really know how else I could describe it. It was like a New York scene where there was like yellow cabs everywhere. And during the sequence of this dream, I was New York's Spider-Man, which isn't a superpower that I would choose. I would never be a superhero like Spider-Man. I would always pick Superman or someone similar. And the really interesting bit about this dream was, not only was I swinging from all the different buildings and helping people get out of the way of cars, but it wasn't limited to Marvel. So Spider-Man is a Marvel property, and my favorite property is DC, and one of my favorite comic book things is Green Lantern. And in this dream, I was chosen to be a Green Lantern. I had the Green Lantern ring, but I don't think I was chosen on purpose. I think it was an accident. Or everyone else around me who was a Green Lantern was chosen on purpose, and they thought, why has this guy been chosen? He's Spider-Man. Like, he doesn't show the emphasis of willpower. And I was in agreement with them. But something happened during the dream in which I was angered by other characters in the dream who were Green Lanterns. And we had, I can't remember their names, but we had a blonde girl who was quite tall, who I assume was someone like a Supergirl type character. We had a group of strange alien creatures who are all Green Lanterns. And I was kind of getting sucked up into this light. So I had the ring on me and I was getting sucked up into this like spotlight that was reaching out into space. And I was like, I need to get a hold of this girl because of the thing that she had done to anger me, which I can't remember. So I was getting sucked away from New York and going up and up and up into space. And at the top of this like beam of light that was coming down from space, there was like a ball of white light, and I'm not entirely sure what it was. But I knew that I had to reach it, but I couldn't reach it because it was like I was swerving. If any of you have played Final Fantasy X and you do the Chocobo minigame where you're trying to race in the Calmlands and you kind of can't really steer it, that's what it was like. So even though I had the general direction that I wanted to go, it was like I couldn't really go forward or up. I was swerving whilst going up, and it was really irritating, really, really irritating. But then, out of nowhere, Superman appeared, and he was a Green Lantern also. But he didn't have like the Green Lantern hue, like you have like an aura of green if you're a lantern in space. He just was Superman, but with a green power ring. And he was really angry at me for some reason. He looked at me and he was quite disgusted with what I was doing or something like that. But the interesting thing about this particular Superman is that it was Tom Welling. It wasn't like Henry Cavill, it wasn't comic book Superman, it was Tom Welling. And he was being like a slightly older Superman from when he left the show. I remember him saying to me that even though I have a ring, I won't survive the light speed movement. In my dream, Green Lanterns could travel faster than the speed of light. And that's how they got to Oa, the Green Lantern planet. So when I got closer and closer to this beam of light and the source of it, which was like a ball in space, I just pressed my ring. Say this is the ball. I just pressed my ring against the ball of light, and I was like outstretched, like proper trying to reach them. And then everything kind of stretched, like it kind of looked like I went through a wormhole. It stretched, and then I saw nothing. And then I was on the planet of Oa. But then instead of being like a Green Lantern on Oa, it kind of felt like I was in a newspaper place, like I was a reporter. So I was in New York again. And I was in the same place that Superman was working, so the Daily Planet. And he was working on a news thing. And this is where it gets weird a little bit. So I just remembered the second dream, which is even weirder. So this first dream, I'm in the Daily Planet, and Clark is talking to me, and he's cool with me now. But then I see him wink like that. Like, huh? Why are you winking? And I turn around and there's a bloke behind me. And I'm like, oh, that's weird. Let me rewind that. And then all of a sudden I was like in control of the dream, like, but as a viewer. So I was rewinding the dream and looking at a different perspective. So I saw Superman wink, but he was winking at this other guy because this other guy and him had a thing, which is weird because Superman is famously not gay. But I kind of clicked that he was gay, but it was a secret. Like, he wasn't meant to show me winking at this other chap. He thought that he was safe to do so, but I just happened to see him. And that's kind of where the dream ended. And it's really interesting because, like, theoretically, if you were to travel faster than the speed of light, things, you wouldn't be able to see anything because you're moving quicker than light can move. So light won't be able to reach your eyes. So you won't be able to see anything. So when I was moving faster than the speed of light, it went, and then I was there. I couldn't see anything. So that was kind of accurate to theory. Whereas the dream in itself, you know, I was experimenting with loads of different superpowers, mainly Spider-Man type things, and I just happened to have a Green Lantern ring. There wasn't much Green Lantern-ness going on, apart from flying through space with the other superheroes. And then I woke up, and then I thought, okay, it's getting early. And I assume it was probably around 8 o'clock when I woke up. And I fell back to sleep. And this second dream is just as balmy, particularly for this one bit inside the dream, which I didn't think was weird until I woke up and thought, the hell was that? I can fly in this dream. I was a person who was able to fly through space again. Space themed, interesting. I was able to fly through space and breathe in a zero atmosphere. Or I didn't need to breathe, whichever one. and I was heading towards a space center, and in the space center I was expecting to see like loads of different people. Like, I was expecting it to be full of workers working at the space center, but there was no one there. It was just me. And it wasn't until I looked around the whole building that I realized that there was another person. So in my dream, I was a worker on this space station, and it was all on one floor. There wasn't like another level. It was all on one floor, but there was a stairway to an office, which was the leader of the space station's office. And you'd walk up the stairs and he would open the door and there'd be the office space. But he wasn't there, obviously. But in his office, there was a little creature who kind of reminded me of a house elf in Harry Potter. So in the space station, he was kind of calling my name. He was like, "Oh, Giz, Giz, look, look, everyone's gone. So come up here and have a look at what there is upstairs." So I thought, "Oh, brilliant. I can have a look, see kind of what the deal is upstairs, because no one's ever been inside the room." And I went upstairs and it was massive. It was huge. Loads of space. He had loads of space. He had a private shower, private bathroom. He had his own little kitchenette type thing. He had a bedroom. He had just everything you need to live comfortably. And it was then when I realized that this guy was using his influence in the space station to further his finance. So he was only there just to get more and more financially successful. He didn't care about the other people. What happened to the other people, I don't know. But I went up the stairs and had a look round, and there was this boarded up area, which was really weird because it felt like it was connected to a cave, like the building was connected to a cave, even though we were in space. So I opened up the little hatch, which was nailed shut, and I could see like cave stuff and darkness and a little bit of bleeding light through where, I don't know. But there were creatures in there as well. But it was like somebody was from Minecraft and they went into a cave and they built like a platform above like the cave thing. And I could see that there was a platform, and I knew that the thing that I needed and the thing that I went to the space station to get was there. But then I heard the house elf type creature call my name again, so I had to close the thing shut. And I went downstairs, and here's where it gets really weird, guys. I look out the door, which is wide open, by the way, and just exposed to space. And even though this dream was realistic, like it looked like this, like this is what I looked like, Marge Simpson, holding Maggie in cartoon form, was flying from Earth into the space station. And I think it was my mum. And she had come up to the space station, explains where I get my superpowers from. She was coming up to the space station to talk to me about how I shouldn't be left on my own, and that she came up, Marge Simpson came up to the space station to make sure that I was okay and that I was getting fed. So she started cooking for me. I mean, what? And when I was in the dream, it felt really normal. It's like, oh, it's my mum coming up, blah, 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 blah. But when I woke up, I thought, the hell was that? Why didn't I click that I was dreaming? I mean, it was all pretty weird, but at least it was based in realism. But then when this surreal cartoon character just flies up towards the space station that you're in, why didn't I click that I was dreaming? It was so bizarre. So bizarre. Yeah, I still don't quite get that. So that's it for this dream vlog video type thing. I know it's a bit weird, but it just goes to show how complex and confusing the dream world can really be. Even when you wake up, you still think, what the hell? I just want to say a big thank you to the Patreon supporters and the YouTube members on this channel. The podcast on Patreon, for those who are in the tier that is worth that much, they are getting really well received. I'm getting some comments, I'm getting some messages about how good they are. I've only released three at the moment. The first one was about how to lucid dream, complete guide to Dialed. The second one was half the length of the first one, and it was about Wild. The third one was about establishing a morning routine for lucid dreaming and what I consider is the best morning routine. And the one that's going to be released this week sometime is all about, it'll potentially be released on Friday. It's going to be all about how to establish an evening routine for lucid dreaming, because routines are quite important. So if you want to listen to those, then check the Patreon page, see the tier that podcasts are part of, and just join and sign up. I'm trying to expand the Patreon page as much as I can, because I feel like you guys are getting a good value for what you're paying. I think podcasts are quite a good source of content, and yeah, just see if you want to join. Also, you get other benefits, like if you're a part of the Patreon page, you also get access to the Discord channel as a special Patreon Discord member. And yeah, that's it. So as I said, I don't know how regular videos are going to be on this channel at the moment, because everything is up in air until next week. That's a weird bird noise. I think that's a crow. Very odd. Yeah, so I'm not sure how regular my videos are going to be. So the Patreon things are still going to go ahead as planned, and the live stream is happening on the 29th of this month, not the 30th. So Thursday will be the live stream. Until next time, whenever that may be, goodbye from me.